Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done. And today we got kind of an unboxing slash review video. Now this is something that I was going to pick up a couple years back, but for whatever reason decided not to. Now they've revamped and redesigned the product, and I'm talking about the Harbor Freight Portable Bandsaw. This has been redesigned. The previous model had 6 amps, this one's got 10, and all the reviews are very favorable, and I got it for about $100. So you really can't go wrong with that price. And if it stands up to what I'm gonna use it for, which is probably gonna be a couple times a year maybe, it was well worth the price. So let's cut this guy open. All right, so there it is. I chose this one, one, because of the price, two, good reviews, three, it came with a case. So the case was kind of the deciding factor for me. As stupid as that sounds, the case was a good thing to me. It was a good factor to consider. So like I said, about $100, and to me, so far, well worth it. So I had this one shipped to the house, so that's why it was in the box. And I'm assuming if you go to the store to pick this up, it won't be in that cardboard box, but I could be wrong. Who knows? You got a couple of zip ties here. Actually, just one of them. So we'll cut this zip tie here. And this case seems very stout. It's, I don't know, it seems solid so far. It's got a couple of heavy-duty clips. Ah, okay, now we're getting somewhere. All right, it does come with a blade, and I have no idea if this blade's considered good or not, but we'll see. It looks like the case itself has storage for the blade. You got the manual up here. Okay, so that's that. And then the bandsaw itself is in plastic. As I mentioned, this is the redesigned model. And the older one had more of a, I guess, like an orangey type of plastic. This has got a reddish color, okay, like most of their electric tools have. And this fits in the case pretty good. Like so. Okay, so that's how it fits in the case. And the blade gets attached and it goes around these wheels here. There's one there, and the blade goes around. This is the cutting area, okay? And, yeah, it goes, I don't know if you could say, but there's these guides. A couple of rollers here and rollers here. That's what keeps the blade straight, or at least where it should be. Okay, it's got a lever for tension, tight versus loose. It's got an auxiliary handle up here. The trigger is right here, and it's got a speed control, so it's adjustable. It's labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then max. So apparently there's 6 speeds, variable speed. All right, so what I'm gonna do next is compare the blade that came with the saw itself to a box of blades that I got. I got a Milwaukee brand bandsaw blade that should be the same size and should fit all these standard portable bandsaws. This is a box that came with 2 blades, and it was about $16 at Home Depot. And like I said, I don't see myself using this more than a few times a year. So these blades, all 3 of these, will probably last me just about forever. Here is the Milwaukee blade, and I don't know if you're going to be able to see those teeth there. And here is the one that came with the Harbor Freight. Now right away, you can see that they're identical in width. Okay, you got the Milwaukee and the Harbor Freight. And it looks like the Milwaukee has slightly deeper teeth. And this is a number of teeth we got here, okay? This is what I got. So it's a 10 by 14 TPI, and you can see the materials that it's good for. What we're gonna do is we're gonna load up, this is the Harbor Freight, we're gonna put that one in there. Now, some of the reviews have said that this is a wood blade, so we'll try it on some scrap and see what happens. One additional thing to note before we actually change the blade is I went in there to grab the manual, just to kind of read over that about changing the blade before I actually get started. I found that it came in a Ziploc bag, and in that Ziploc bag were additional brushes and an Allen wrench. So this is not a brushless motor, and I wasn't expecting it to be, but the extra brushes are a good sign. And this was all tucked away where the manual goes in the case. And this probably weighs about, I'm guessing just under 20 pounds. Not too sure exactly, but that's what it feels like. So the blade tension is set to loose. Install the blade with teeth up towards you. The trick is, if you look carefully here, those rollers that the blade has to go between are at a different angle than the big wheels. Okay, so I don't know if that's just gonna show up on camera sufficiently, but, oh wait, as I look at this, there's a warning right there. It says included 14 TPI blade is for cutting wood and other soft material. Use 24 TPI blades sold separately to cut cast iron and steel. All right, so that's that. This must be a wood blade then. So let's get this thing installed. All right, so I got the blade just about on. It was a little tricky getting it into these rollers because, as you can see, it's straight here, and then it kind of bows or bends upward to go around these rollers like we mentioned earlier. Then all you got to do is, I'll show you this on the other side, you got to tighten the blade by flipping that tension. So it goes theoretically to the correct tension every time. So like we mentioned, you got the, it's all the way to tight now, you see, it's all the way down there tight. Before, it was all the way turned around to loose. And all that did was take this one wheel, all right, and pushes it out to put tension on the blade itself. All right, so I got gloves, I got eye protection on. Let's put it on speed 3 and see about cutting this 2x4. Wow, this thing is pretty awesome. It does help, and I probably should have realized this, that if you have the piece you're working on right up against that tool rest here, so not the tool rest, but you know what I mean right here, this piece, okay? Put that on there, it minimizes vibration, it seems. Okay, well, that was pretty awesome. Okay, to change out the blade, first thing you want to do is release the tension. And we'll see if you can see this. Watch this gear here. Unplug it first. Watch this gear here as I release the tension. Hopefully you can see it move. Okay, well that alone just popped the blade out. So, get this blade out of here. It would be a good idea to somehow label this as a wood blade. You don't get them mixed up. Okay, I'm gonna put the new metal blades in and see what happens. All right, so I got a piece of stock here, about 1/4 inch thick. We'll do gloves and goggles, we plug back in. We have the Milwaukee blade in now, and this is supposed to be a metal blade. Even though the tool itself recommends a much higher tooth blade, we'll see what happens. I'm gonna keep it on the same speed, and we're shooting for just a cut straight down here. So let's see how this guy does it. Wow. Okay, well, the non-straight cut was me, not the tool itself. I just got to get better at making straight cuts. All right, well, from my minimal use just now, cutting a piece of wood, cutting a piece of metal, you can at least see what this saw is capable of doing right out of the box. I didn't lube anything, I didn't grease anything up, it was just ready to go. Changed out the blades, showed you how to do that, and so far, I recommend this tool. It's seems like a solid piece of machinery, at least one of the better ones from Harbor Freight, considering that they've recently redesigned this. So this is the new portable bandsaw, not the old one that you've seen all the other videos on. This is the new one. Comes with a really good solid case. The only gripe I have so far is that the blade storage compartment, I guess you can call it, it's really only good for one blade. I got three blades in there right now. I was going to store it with the blade attached, so I only had two up here, but when I released the tension to put it in the case, the blade popped off. Now, I probably could have just jammed it back on there and let it stay there that way, but when it popped off, it popped off, so I put the blade up here. There's got to be a better way for blade storage, but it's the first bandsaw blade storage that comes with this saw that Harbor Freight has put out, so it's an improvement over nothing. All right, so that's my short video on the Harbor Freight portable bandsaw. And I'll put the item number in the description with a link to the actual website with it. And I think this is a good buy for about $100 with a coupon and things like that. Well, if you like this video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I can be found on Twitter at Getting Junk Done. Don't forget to check out the two Getting Junk Done stores. You can find the links on the final screen. Thanks for watching.